to be a gypsy's lady. I care not for my house and land. I care not for my baby. I care not for my rich young lord. I'll be a gypsy's lady. Soon this lady changed her mind. Her clothes grew old and faded. Her hose and shoes come off her feet and left them bare and naked. What befell this lady now? I think it's worth relating. Her gypsy found another lass and left her heart a-breaking.
Did you ever go to meetin' Uncle Joe, Uncle Joe? Did you ever go to meetin' Uncle Joe, Uncle Joe? Did you ever go to meetin' Uncle Joe, Uncle Joe? I don't mind the weather, so the wind don't blow. How's your rheumatism, Uncle Joe, Uncle Joe? And how's your rheumatism, Uncle Joe, Uncle Joe? How's your rheumatism, Uncle Joe, Uncle Joe? I don't mind the weather, so the wind don't blow.
Thank you. was a fair farm among them whose cries did rend the air. There was a fair farm among them, a girl from Saginaw town, whose moans and cries rose to the skies for her lover who'd gone down. Fair Clara was a noble girl, a river man's true friend. She and her widowed mother lived at the river's bend, and the wages of her own true love the boss to her did pay. But the shanty boys for her made up a generous purse next day. They buried him quite decently, 'twas on the 1st of May. Come all you brave young shanty boys, and for your comrades pray. Engraved upon the hemlock tree that by the grave does grow is the aged date and the sad fate of the foreman, young Monroe. Fair Clara did not long survive, her heart broke with her grief, and less than 3 months afterwards death came to her relief. And when the time had come and she was called to go, her last request was granted to be laid by young Monroe. Come all you brave young shanty boys, I'd have you call and see to green graves by the riverside where grows a hemlock tree. The shanty boys cut off the wood where lay those lovers low. 'Tis the handsome Clara Vernon and her true love, young Monroe.